Hello, I'm Lauren Laverne. Welcome back to Maida Vale Studios in West London. I can't believe we're already coming to the end of our week of Six Music Live, but what a week it's been. We've been celebrating the best in live music with Block Party, Left Field, The Staves and Mercury Rev. And today it's the turn of one of the most influential bands of all time. They've been going for an incredible 35 years and are currently celebrating the release of the new album, Music Complete, which features guest appearances from Iggy Pop, Brandon Flowers and LaRue, who'll be joining them on stage today. Here, playing some exclusive new tracks for the first time and of course some classics, it's New Order.
Thank you. guys. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Okay, I'd like to welcome to the stage at the moment Ellie Jackson from LaRue. If she's not gone home. Oh, she is still here, Ellie. What a fool.
Space.
you.
I have the whole of New Order, today's guests, on stage right now. Hello and welcome to you all. So this is a building that you've got a bit of history with, because, you know, you've done quite a few Peel sessions here in your time. When, do you remember when the first one was? When would it have been?
I don't. I remember it being Joy Division. I remember playing Love Will Tear Us Apart, and we couldn't get my keyboard working, so we had to hire at the last minute a rather dodgy keyboard that didn't sound as good. Okay. That's about all I remember about. Oh, yeah, I remember bailing out in a session once because Keith Allen told us there was a party just around the corner.
Oh, really? We're done here. That's fine. I'm happy with that mix.
I got my phone ringing.
So the new album's out now, Music Complete. It sounds, you know, to me like it's been getting a fantastic response. How's it been from your perspective?
Yeah, it has been getting a fantastic response, and which was very rewarding, obviously, because we worked really hard on it. And I mean, you're always proud of every album that you release. I think this one's taken a turn towards electronica and synthesizers, and I think we just managed to get that kind of synergy with our fans and obviously with journalists for once, like us, you know. It does seem to have worked because the album's doing really, really well.
I read a great recent quote from you about being in New Order, which was like saying it's like being in a house, living in a house that you're just in all the time, and people keep asking you what the outside of the house looks like, and you have no idea because you experience it from the inside out.
Yeah, that's right, and the inverse works as well, because the people on the outside don't really know what the inside looks like. They know what the house looks like, and oh, it's just been decorated, you know, it's just been painted, but they don't know what goes on inside. And obviously some of it isn't very nice, some of it is nice. They can't see what goes on inside. Sometimes that's a good thing, though.
It's like the swan legs, you know, underneath the beautiful gliding.
I think people get like a caricature of the members of the band, that they think people are like this, but it's also slightly wrong. It's a bit like watching an actor on television playing James Bond or something, and then when you meet him, you expect him to behave like James Bond, you know.
Tell me a bit about making the album, because you're working with some really brilliant people, as well as the guest vocalists that we've got on the mix. You know, there's Iggy there, Brandon Flowers does a track, also Ellie from LaRue is there as well, and Tom Rowlands too, who was working on some of the tracks.
Yeah, he's not singing on it though.
No, not as a vocalist, but you know, he was collaborating with you. Yeah.
And there's other people as well that are perhaps not quite as famous. There's Dawn Z, who's a vocalist from Manchester, and Denise Johnson, who's famous for her work.
She worked with
Primal Scream and Electronic. I think it's nice to have the freedom within the band to do that, because it opens your mind, you know, instead of it just being the five of us and it being very, you know, that's it. It means you can do more, really. It's more, I don't know, it's just more forms of expression.
More options, kind of thing.
Sometimes they can do things that we can't do. So, you get someone in who can do something that you can't do. And it sort of strengthens your bow, you know, and gives you more creative possibilities, yeah.
Well, we're delighted to have you here today.
Thank you.
And couldn't be more excited that you've chosen to share some of the songs with us for the first time. Thank you so much, Bernard. And New
Order,
thank you very much for being here.
We'll be right back. Thank you.
Well, that's almost your lot. What a week it's been for Six Music Live, with some cracking performances from Block Party, Left Field, The Staves and Mercury Rev, all from here in Studio 3 at Maida Vale. Do hope you've had as much fun as we have. Don't forget, you can catch up on anything that you might have missed at bbc.co.uk/sixmusic. I'll be back with my radio show weekdays between 10 a.m. and 1 p.m. on BBC Radio 6 Music, and you can now download the entire show via the iPlayer radio app. But to close out the 6 Music Live, there's just about time for one more from New Order. See you soon.
Let me hit the ground tonight.
Thank you.